Your knee joint is composed of muscle, bone, tendons, cartilage, and a capsule called the synovium, which is a bit like the sump on an auto engine. Cartilage allows for free movement of the joint, which is lubricated by synovial fluid, the physiological equivalent of Duckham's multigrade. In an arthritic knee, the cartilage thins out and roughens. In order to compensate, the bone can thicken and grows lumps and bumps on the ends called osteophytes. We all know that back in the bad old days, when you bought a new car, you spent the running in period knocking the rough spots off the pistons. This process appears to be a reverse of that, whereby your bones grow fresh rough spots. The synovium, determined not to be outdone by a pair of glorified calcium girders, may deliver them more fluid than is necessary, and things begin to get complicated. If you push too much oil through a mechanical system, you risk blowing the seals, but your knees don't have any seals to blow. The excess synovial fluid makes them swell, and they become lumpy and bumpy and battered. A bit like cheap fish fingers from the supermarket. While all this is going on, the ligaments make an effort to pull the knee back into shape. That weakens the muscles and may cause your knee to give way. The upshot of all this is a knee that's worse than useless. If it was only useless, you could just limp. But because it's worse than useless, you've got to limp and grimace at the same time. And if you're not up to multitasking, you are deep in the SH1T. Because I'm not a doctor, this is necessarily a simplified overview of the process. Arthritis can't be cured, but there are surgical procedures that can help. Like replacing the body panels on a 1947 Ford Prefect, you can have hips and knees replaced. Like the body panels for a 1947 Ford Prefect, you can't buy the spare parts on eBay. I know, I checked. Mind you, I also checked for spare parts for 1947 Ford Prefects, and they didn't have any of them either. So there's hope yet.